In ancient imperial China, Chinese women have always been oppressed by a patriarchal society. Under the constraints of rules and dogma formed over thousands of years, women became the property of male members of the family. They were restricted from participating in various realms of social life. Women in ancient China did not enjoy the status, either social or political, afforded to men. Women were subordinate to first their fathers, then their husbands, and finally, in the case of being left a widow, their sons in a system known as the Sangkong, three followings. The rule that a woman without talent is virtue was also one of them. Women were deprived of the right to education and could not learn to read and write like men. Under the oppression of social rules, women in the Yongshu area of Hunan, China, invented a mysterious script called Nushu, which was used to convey information and express emotions between women. This script has never appeared in Chinese historical records, nor is there any trace of it in local genealogies or inscriptions. In 1982, while searching for the Qianjia cave site in the Yongshu area, Gong Zibing, a teacher at Wuhan University, accidentally discovered a script that had never been seen before. He subsequently published a report on the investigation of this mysterious and unknown script, which caused a sensation in the academic community, and the veil of mystery surrounding Nushu was finally lifted. So who created Nushu? Why was it created? Why is it not recorded in historical records? And why is it only passed down among women? China's southeastern Hunan province is a dramatic jigsaw puzzle of precipitous sandstone peaks, deeply incised river valleys, and fog-shrouded rice paddy fields. Mountains cover more than 80% of the area, leaving many isolated hillside hamlets to develop independently of one another. Jianjing County is located in Yongshu City, Hunan Province, a city where multiple ethnic groups live together. Jianjing is a very mysterious area, because it is a convergence of various cultures and geographical features. For example, in most parts of China, rivers flow from west to east, but there is a river in Jianjing called Tashui, which flows from east to west and eventually flows into the Pearl River. It was here, hidden amongst the rocky slopes and rural river villages, where Nushu was born, the only writing system in the world created and used exclusively by women. There are several different legends about the origin of Nushu.
进封不久了，就说受到冷落，在会想被杀，他就写了一封信啊，告诉家里，在防空的七彩啊，今日告诉西乡的有女儿不要嫁进防空。Nushu
is currently the only surviving gender-specific script in the world.
这一般是从上到下，从右往左，右整个字形特别是右高左低，从斜平行的。它不像这个汉字翻翻增增，而且它的笔画呢很简单，就四个笔画：点、竖、斜、弧。但这个左斜、右斜、左和右横。Nushu
can express multiple meanings in a single character, distinguishing synonyms through contextual meaning. It can fully record the local Chinese language and dialects, using less than 400 letters, making it a mature Chinese writing system. Nushu strictly prohibited men from learning it. In order to prevent men from understanding its meaning, women slightly altered the tone and communicated through singing. Nushu works are mostly in the form of poetry with a fixed number of characters, mostly in 7-character lines. They were written on exquisitely crafted fans, paper, cloth and clothing. Many of the Nushu writings are poetic, written in a structured style, and were written about marriage, including about the sorrow of separation. Other writings are letters from women to women, as they found through this female-only script, a way to keep in communication with their female friends. Most express feelings, and many are about sorrow and misfortune. Like other writing systems, Nushu has been passed down to modern times through various means of transmission. In the process of transmitting Nushu, in addition to being taught by female elders within the family, the most distinctive method is the third-day missives. Local women will receive congratulatory letters from their natal family and female friends on the third day after their marriage. These letters usually describe the sadness of leaving their parents and how to get along with their husband after marriage. If a newlywed wife does not receive congratulations from her family and friends, it is considered a shame. The practice of congratulating newlyweds on the third day is common in other parts of China, but only in the Jianjing area do women use Nushu to write these congratulatory letters. Because Nushu was secret, with no references to it found in documents or genealogies, and many of the writings buried with the women who possessed the writings. So the surviving examples of Nushu are very rare. The original manuscripts of women's books currently excavated in archaeological excavations are all third-day missives. With the development of the local economy and the advancement of modern communication, fewer and fewer women are learning and mastering Nushu. As time goes by, this female-exclusive script has encountered unprecedented challenges.
Bye.